Yes, I. Today's message is very deep, very important, and I really want you to understand this. Karma is not only direct karma, karma is also indirect karma. So when you cause harm to somebody directly, absolutely straight in the face, that is also karma. And when you do something indirect, which becomes cause for somebody's pain or suffering, that is also your karma only. Just because it went indirectly through someone else does not take away the karma from you. And this is a very important thing to be noted and remembered. You should be so careful, so careful, so careful about three types of energies that you carry. Those that are in the physical body, those that are in the thought and emotion body, and then the energy body purely. So karma is not at one plane of existence. I always tell you, what you think is your first karma, then how you act is your next karma, and the energy that you carry with it is your karma too. Everything has to be changed. Today, if we are not living lives the way we want to, today if people believe that everything is predestined and my future, my destiny, or my present for that matter, is not in my control, why do we feel like this? Why do we feel weak before the destiny? Why do we feel that we can't change our karma? It is simply because we are living our lives unaware at every single moment. It's like driving your car unconsciously. We are living our lives unconsciously. When you drive your car, you don't tell yourself, change the gear, turn the steering. It just happens habitually. So also we are living our lives habitually in the way it is. Unless we become conscious of each thing that we say, do or act upon, we cannot change our karma. You have to be so careful about that first thought that comes into your mind. You have to be so careful about how you act on that thought, the actual action. And most importantly, you have to be careful about the energy that your action carries. The energy is so, so, so important. And my learning experience in this life has been that karma, the way it is done directly and indirectly, there is direct damage and indirect. So the biggest thing that we have to be careful about is our thoughts and our speech more than the actions. Hitting, slapping, beating happens much later. But the thought and the words are continuous in our life. Sometimes we use the words because we have to use the words in a situation. But let me tell you, really hear this very carefully. When I say something bitter to somebody, whatever the reason be, and that person gets hurt. You know, in Hindi we say a word, hai. They say hai lagti hai. It means when that person sighs in pain, does that long deep breath of hurt, the energy which comes out has to come back to you one day. Do we want to take such energies? Oh no, we don't. And here I come to my next point. When the energies come back to us also, again they come back direct and indirect. Direct means it comes to me and affects me because I have done the wrong. Indirect is it comes to my own people around me. It could be my dear ones, my family, my parents, my children, my siblings, whosoever, who's mine. And trust me, when a problem comes to me, I can deal with it because I'm strong. I'm talking for each of us. When it comes to us, we are very strong with it. But when it comes on our own people, oh my God, it is so difficult to deal with it. And then that problem may not have come because they have done something wrong. That could have come because I have done something wrong, because it is collective karma after all. Changing life is very simplified. All you have to do is become observant of your own karma. Become careful about your own deeds. You have to understand that you have to keep observing everything you do in the day. And when you become conscious of it is when you can change it. Otherwise, we are living our lives like driving that car. Unconscious living. Everything is happening the way it is just happening. We haven't even thought about it. But when you think about it consciously and start working upon it, that is where you can change it. And then I'm going to read some lines from the Bhagavad Gita. I'm not reading the shloka because you will not follow the shloka, but I'm going to read the explanation of the shloka. It goes, my dear Krishna, I am not at all afraid of the thunderbolt of King Indra, nor am I afraid of the serpentine, piercing trident of Lord Shiva. I do not care about the punishment of Yamaraja, the superintendent of death, nor am I afraid of fire, scorching sun, moon, wind, nor the weapons of Kubera. Yet I am afraid of offending a being. I am very much afraid of this. Just imagine, what is the fear? It's not of death, it is not of Yama, it is not of any other, anything which you may think can bring fear. The fear here is of something as simple as offending or hurting a being. That is what you have to understand. When you hurt somebody, when you cause someone pain, it comes back manifold. And in one single day, how many words do you speak harshly? How many actions do you do thoughtlessly? How many things do you say thoughtlessly? Sometimes even without realizing we say things, the other person just goes hurt and quiet inside. Do you know what that hurt brings back to you? It brings terrible energy. And like I said, life is all about collective karma. If I had to bear the brunt of it, I would still go through it. But knowing that when I come to this world, I come as a family and we all live collective karma, that the impact of my karma can go on my dear one, how careful I have to be, because everything is interconnected here, interwoven here. For you to suffer, they have to suffer. And when they suffer, you suffer more. That is why I say be careful about your thoughts, your words, your action, your energies. So on that note, wishing you well. Ya Sai.